You will thank me. Your phone is literally depending on that.
Hey guys, it's Katie, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I will show you how to film and edit on your iPhone. Now, I do not know if my editing tips will help you if you are editing on a Samsung phone, because I've never had one, so I don't know how to edit there. Also, I have to clarify that I do edit on my iPad, but iMovie on iPad and on iPhone is the same way. First of all, I will show you how to film on your phone, and if you're not interested, then you can skip to this part because I don't want you to waste your time. I have the iPhone 11, but you totally don't need like the newest phone. Most of my videos have been filmed on my iPhone 7 Plus, and it was really good quality, not gonna lie. So if you have like a phone from like 3 years ago or even 4, the camera quality is still very good. And if you're a newer channel, then bro, that is amazing, okay? Maybe the audio quality will not be as crisp or as nice, but honestly, that is not the end of the world. So guys, the biggest tip I have for you is to find a place in your house where the lighting is good and preferably is closed. Why would you want it closed? Because if not, the audio will echo a lot. This is my room, but I don't usually film here. I film in the guest room because the natural lighting is so much better than on my room. Because on my room, I really don't get that much lighting. So I have to use a lighting. Let me show you. Those lights are part of that mirror, and that's what I use to get kind of goodish lighting on my room because it's really not that great. My second biggest tip for you guys is to have a tripod. Honestly, buy one. And you can find really good ones for like $20. And that's really not that expensive for something that you will use all the time. Trust me, I use my tripods religiously. And sometimes it's even helpful for school projects. So yeah, tripods are so freaking necessary. And let me show you something. You have to make sure that your tripod comes with this, because this is what's going to hold your camera or your phone. And if you're going to film on your phone, then you can get this top part. I think I ripped this from my old selfie stick. And here is where you will place your phone, and that's it. Then you take the square and you screw it on the bottom of the selfie stick thing. You screw it in, make sure that it's very sturdy because your phone is literally depending on that, and then you put it on the tripod. And that is how you set your phone. My third tip is to buy a phone with at least 64 gigabytes of storage. You will thank me. When I started doing YouTube videos, I had an iPhone 5 with 16 gigabytes of storage. I was so stressed out because my videos were barely 5 minutes long because my phone could not handle more. It was a struggle. Another thing you can do to improve your camera quality is go on settings and then go to camera and then say record video. This is what's going to improve the quality or decrease the quality of your videos. I have mine at 4K with 30 frames per second. Although it makes my videos heavier, it makes the quality much, much, much better. And even 1080p with 30 frames per second is really good. And the more frames per second, the smoother your video will be. Also, while you're filming, please turn on airplane mode. That way, the notifications will not come in and your video will not get interrupted. Clean your phone's lens before filming, because sometimes fingerprints make the image blurry and you will have to refilm your video if you don't notice it. And if you edit on another device like I do and you don't know how to send your photos, it's very simple. Just go on photos, select the videos that you want, and on the bottom left of the screen, you will see like this square, and then it has this arrow pointing upwards. Just select that and then go to AirDrop and select the name of your device, and that's it. Now I will be receiving the video. Now that you know how to film on your phone, it's time to edit. The app I personally use is iMovie, and if your phone is maybe 3 years old, iMovie probably comes installed already. So you touch iMovie, and you will have this plus sign, which you will touch, and then touch on movie, which is on the left side. Then you select the videos that you want, and on the bottom you touch create movie. That's how you import your videos to iMovie.
If this appears on your iMovie, the way you make it bigger is just by doing this with your fingers. Also, something very useful is to turn on this, because if you don't, then it's gonna be harder for you to know where you're talking and when you're taking breaths or breaks. So turn that on. Say you're taking a breath here. All you have to do to take that out is touch on the video, split, and then split again. And then you will have your own little video where you don't talk. You touch that again, and on the bottom, the right side, just touch the trash can which says delete, and you will delete it. If you deleted something that you didn't want to delete, you can go in the same place we went for the audio and touch on the arrow, and then you can undo that multiple times. But be careful, because sometimes you cannot undo everything, because it will tell you like, do you want to delete the project? And of course you don't want that. Most people don't. And those are the principles for rough cuts. Rough cuts are basically the time where you cut up all the video to make it the length you wanted. Some tips I have for you is to edit the rough cuts in 30 minute spans, because trust me, rough cuts take very long. And my second tip is to leave as little breaks as possible, because that will distract the viewer and make them head out. Every time you cut a video or you add two videos together, you will see this little square. That means that there is a transition there. I personally don't like transitions, but you can honestly play with all of them. But I have none, and that's how I like my videos. But you can put whatever transition you want. Now, how to do time lapses. Touch on the video and then go to speed, which is the second icon. It's to the right of actions, and then you will see this timeline. If you move the circle to the left, it will make your video slower, and if you move it to the right, it will make them faster. Something I do if my videos are not as fast as I want them to is I just keep saving the video. You can only make it faster until 2x, which is fast, but sometimes if you're doing a time lapse, that is really not enough. All you have to do is make the time lapse as fast as possible, then save the video, and do that as many times as you would like. But be careful, because that can be dangerous for some people and make them dizzy. The last thing for my basics category is how to add filters. Filters are very easy. Again, touch on the video and go to the farthest option you have to the right, which will be filters, and then you just select the one you want, and that is it. Now, onto the more fun things, but not as fun yet. Music. I love always changing my music, and it's honestly one of the things I enjoy most. Where I find my music is on Thematic, which is a place that every YouTuber uses, and I also use SoundCloud. Now, please, it's very important that you use music that is not copyrighted, because if you get monetized, those videos will not make you a cent. And also, please support smaller artists. That is what I do with my videos. Two of my favorite SoundCloud artists are Daphne and Mama Ayuto. I don't know how to pronounce it. I'm so sorry. I always link them down below. Also, using smaller artists' songs means that you will not get copyrighted. And if you're not sure that that song is copyright free, you can post a video on private and see if it gets copyrighted. If it does, then you know it's copyrighted and you cannot use that song. Another thing that I love are my sound effects. I am obsessed with my sound effects, okay guys? I'm telling you. I find most of mine through YouTube. You can also find them on the internet or on iMovie. iMovie has some, but I don't like them. They're kind of ugly and simple. All you have to do is go on YouTube and search sound effects that YouTubers use and screen record the ones you like. That's it. The ones I use the most are mouse click, ding, and bottle cork. How you add them is very simple. Just select the screen recording you want, you touch on the screen recording, and you will see three options: a plus sign, a play button, and three dots. You will touch on the three dots and say audio only, and then you will match the audio to where you want it to be. And see? Okay, you cannot hear it because I'm using a video that has sound, but whatever. Now, the things in the category that are really fun, which are my favorite part of editing, are green screens, overlays, everything that has to do with adding things to your video to make them more interesting. How do you do this? Just go on YouTube, search overlays or VHS overlays, screen record that, and
Then you go to iMovie, touch on the screen recording, and touch on the three dots, and then say green/blue screen. And see, you will have your overlay. You can also make your own overlays if you can. Personally, I use Procreate. Just draw the things that you would like. You save that as a GIF, I think. Then you convert that using an app or an online service, and you transform that from GIF to video, and that's it. Another thing that I use a lot to make this is Fonto. Fonto will be your best friend, honestly. If you don't want to use the ugly text that iMovie gives you, Fonto will be your best friend. Go into Fonto, then open plain images, select the white one or the black one, and then width you will write 1280, and then on height you will write 720, and then you change the color to green. And then just write whatever you want. And you can change the font and do whatever you would enjoy. For example, I can do it red or something. But something that you do have to keep in mind is that since we're using green/blue screen, you cannot use text that is green or a text that is blue because it would look transparent. So yeah, those are all the tips that I have for you today. If I forgot to write something, I will say it on the video. I am sorry if it's hard to understand. I really tried my best. But yeah, I really hope I helped at least one person. If you like this video, please like, subscribe, and comment down below what you want to see next. Okay, love you. Bye!
You mean bread and butterflies?
Oh yes, of course.
Oh,